Okay, here we are today in one of our homes at Giri. Okay, we are going to show you a home where we are starting our second home for homeless street women. This is a nice place. All rooms having AC, well ventilated. Okay, comfortable to hold 15 street women. It's all loaded, all kitchen equipment, cutlery, crockery, gas stove, utensils, fridge, a nice room for the in charge to stay. Again, air conditioned, toilets, in case there is extra guest, a guest can sleep here along with the in charge. Waiting to start this home in the new year. The situation is we have the home, it's loaded, we have people ready to move into the home, washing machine. We have the people ready to move into the home, but we don't have caregivers. We don't have caregivers. Two washing machines, because you get different types of people off the street. Small office. Again, air conditioner here. Nice balcony. Greenery in the front, total green. And what can we say? We have been given this home to use, it's not ours, by a couple from Giri, Aura and Lawrence. They have been kind enough to give it to us at a very, very, very minimum rent, just as a token amount. Our current home at Saligaon is completely filled. No chance to put more, and here we can accommodate another 15 of them. And we are praying and keeping prayers high that, you know, two caregivers come along, multiple people on the street. You have the facility, you have the infrastructure, and you don't have the caregivers. Whereas in a men's home, we have the men and we don't have a home. That's for another day. So in case anybody would like to be a caregiver, anybody would like to work for the poorest of the poor, anybody would like to serve the poor homeless street woman, this home is only for homeless street woman, kindly get in touch with us. We are grateful to Aura and Lawrence from Giri for allowing us to hold this home for the last 7-8 months, but somehow we have not been able to get caregivers. We know the pandemic has just getting over and may restart again with the second strain, but keeping my hopes high, keeping my prayers high, and I'm sure that in the due course of time, we will be able to start this home and look after another 15, at least 15-20 homeless street women who will get a clean place to stay, food, clothing, shelter. In fact, this property also has a fridge where Aura and her husband runs the food bank, and there is a full-fledged kitchen which we intend to use the ladies from this home to run that food bank kitchen, so that, you know, at least they'll be occupied and we can bring our costing down for our meals on wheels, or bring our costing down for the breakfast outside government hospitals. So it's a two-way project. It's a rehabilitation home as well as it's a kitchen, full-fledged kitchen in the same vicinity, which Aura and Lawrence run a fridge and they feed about 30 people every day in the morning, and also there is a facility to cook food, big full-fledged kitchen. Thank you so much. God bless you.